Hello friends, welcome back to the Design Patterns video series. In this video, I'm going to discuss lazy loading versus eager loading of singleton instance in singleton design pattern with examples. Please watch our previous video where we discussed how to make the singleton instance thread safe in singleton design pattern. At the end of this video, you will understand the following pointers. First, we will discuss what is eager loading or non-lazy loading in C#. Then we will discuss what is lazy loading or deferred loading in C#. Then we will discuss lazy keyword which was introduced as part of a .NET framework 4. And finally, we will discuss how to make the singleton instance thread safe using both eager loading and lazy loading in C#. Right? So let us proceed and understand what is eager loading, or you can say non-lazy loading in C#. The eager loading is nothing but a process, or you can say it is a mechanism in which we will initialize the singleton object at the time of application startup rather than on demand and keep it ready in memory to be used in the future. The advantage of using eager loading or non-lazy loading in singleton design pattern is that CLR, that is common language runtime, will take care of object initialization and thread safety. That means as a developer, we do not require to write any code explicitly for handling the thread safety for a multi-threaded environment, right? Let us understand the eager loading or non-lazy loading of singleton instance in singleton design pattern with one example. Let us move to Visual Studio Editor. Let us modify the singleton class as follows. First, we do not require to write any code explicitly for handling the thread safety. So let us remove the static read-only object. Then make the singleton variable as read-only and initialize at the time of its declaration. So make the singleton instance as read-only and we need to initialize this at the time of its declaration, right? Now, we also don't require the lock or double lock checking mechanism anymore, right? So what we need to do is we simply need to return the singleton instance from the get instance property without checking any condition. So what we need to do is simply return this instance from the get instance property. That's it. We are done with our eager loading implementation for singleton design pattern. So in this case, when the application starts, the static variable gets executed, that is the singleton instance created at the time of application startup and ready to be used by our application. This is because static members are executed at the application startup and they are also executed only once in their lifetime, right? Then when we invoke the get instance property, then it simply returns the singleton instance which is already created. Once the client gets the singleton instance, then he can call the printDetails method using the singleton object. Now let's move to the client code. In our example, program class is the client, right? As you can see in the program class, we have two methods, right? printTeacherDetails and printStudentDetails. And as you can see in each method, I'm doing the same thing, that is calling the getInstance property of the singleton class to get the singleton instance. And once you get the singleton instance, then we are calling the printDetails method, right? And then we invoke these two methods parallelly using the parallel.invoke method. What the parallel.invoke method will do is, it will create two threads and invoke these methods parallelly that we already discussed in our previous video. That means these two methods are going to be executed at the same time by two different threads. As these two methods are executed at the same time, that means two threads access the same get instance property parallelly, right? Now run the application and see the output. Yes, you can see the counter value is 1, which means the private constructor of the singleton class executed only once, which also means that only one instance of the singleton class is created. This singleton class is also thread safe after removing the locking mechanism. This is because now the CLR, that is common language runtime, will take the responsibility for the variable initialization as well as thread safety in eager loading. Now, I hope you understand how to implement eager loading in Singleton Design Pattern. Now, let us proceed and understand lazy loading or deferred loading in C sharp. Let us go back to the presentation. The lazy loading or deferred loading is a mechanism that is used to delay the initialization of an object until the point at which it is required. So the main objective of lazy loading or deferred loading is that it is load the singleton object on demand, or you can say when the object is required. The most important point that you need to keep in mind is you need to use the lazy loading or deferred loading in C sharp or in real-time applications when the cost of the object creation is very high, as well as the use of that object is very rare. The lazy loading or deferred loading improves the performance of the application if it is used properly. In C sharp, we can use the lazy keyword to make the singleton instance lazy loading. So let us first understand the lazy keyword. The lazy keyword was introduced as part of a .NET framework 4.0, and it provides the built-in support for lazy initialization of an object, that is on-demand object initialization. If you want to make an object such as singleton as lazily initialized, then you just need to pass the type of the object to the lazy keyword as follows, right? So you need to provide the class name to the lazy keyword, and here we need to specify the class name which we want to make lazy loading, and then to the constructor of lazy of t, we need to provide the singleton object by using lambda expression. The most important point that you need to keep in mind is the lazy of t objects are by default thread safe. That is, in a multi-threaded environment, when multiple threads are trying to access the same get instance property at the same time, then the lazy object will take care of thread safety. Let us move to Visual Studio and see how to implement lazy loading of the singleton instance in Singleton Design Pattern. In Singleton class, we will do two changes. First, we need to use the lazy keyword to create the singleton instance as follows, right? So here we need to use the lazy keyword. And to the constructor, we need to pass the lambda expression specifying the object. Okay. Once we created the singleton instance using the lazy keyword, then we need to access the value property of the lazy object, which will return the singleton instance as follows. So here we need to access the value property which will return the singleton instance. That's it. We are done with our lazy loading of singleton instance implementation. So let us run the application and see the output. Yes, here we got the same output as eager loading. This is because of the lazy keyword, which creates only one singleton instance, and also they are by default thread safe. This is the reason why we do not get any errors while invoking the methods parallelly. Now I hope you also understand the concept of lazy loading in C sharp. Let's go back to the presentation. What next? In the next video, I'm going to discuss one real-time example of singleton design pattern, that is error logging. Here in this video, I try to explain lazy loading versus eager loading in singleton design pattern with examples. I hope you enjoy this video. In case you need the code and text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. Thank you for watching this video.